Hi, my name is Sayan Mukherjee, and I'm a professor, and I have primary appointments in statistical science and mathematics, and I have secondary appointments in computer science and biostatistics, bioinformatics. Two areas that I've been thinking about working in, and both applied work as well as theoretical and methodological work. One is, how do I think about data that are really complex or strange? Things like shapes, things like surfaces, right? Things that aren't just a number or a vector, right? Things that have a really, really complicated structure. And how do I use them to make predictions or understand them better? For example, how much can you explain of a clinical phenotype like disease-free survival from the shape of a brain tumor? Okay, and let's say if you could start answering the questions, what subparts of the tumor are most relevant in making that prediction? So that's one part of it, really thinking about these static, complicated objects. Another part of it is I work in math, it's called dynamics, and statistics, it's called time series. How do I think about time-varying data, right? Some of these could be stochastic time-varying data. Sometimes you have deterministic time-varying data. How do I know that the approaches I'm taking have some guarantees, are reasonable? How do I estimate uncertainty in my estimates, right? And examples of this, for example, we've been asking the following question. We have access to this data set of, I don't know, maybe about over 100 baboons, maybe around 160 baboons, and we have very detailed information on their poop over many, many years. And we're asking the following question. How correlated is variation in the microbiome to the hosts and the environment of the host? Because we have very detailed genetic, social, demographic information on these baboons, what they eat, who they, I don't know, who they groom, things like that, right? So we're really trying to understand this type of variation. That's one example. There are other examples, but yeah, these complex time-varying data that have really intricate dependencies. So I think a lot of the work that I do is at the interface of, there's some version of this where people have applied people they work with, or they have biologists they work with, or others that they work with. But there's a lot of work that I do that actually sits at the interface of different mathematical disciplines, like at the interface of stats and math, or interface of CS and stats, right? And what IID is tremendously useful for is having meetings and being able to coordinate and work in a space, right, that really is at the interface, right? Because you're not sitting in your department. You are somewhere else where there are others who come from slightly different backgrounds, right? And being able to kind of coordinate that, have students talk back and forth between these and build in those intersection areas, it's been a real boon to have a place like IID to be able to enable that.